Today we will start interval and fuzzy numbers. So you have already we have discussed why we need fuzzy variable, fuzzy constant, etc. in my first two lectures. Okay, so we have here interval numbers and fuzzy numbers. So we have then we'll discuss about interval arithmetic, fuzzy arithmetic, how to add two fuzzy numbers, subtract, divide, multiply, etc. Similarly for interval. If you know the interval, that can be extended to fuzzy also. Okay. So why we need these interval numbers in actual practical applications? As I told in the first class, that if I want to measure this, okay, so you may do a means mistake or error there may be in the measurement. It depends upon the person who is measuring. Okay, suppose I say that this is your 3 centimeter, so you can say that no, it is 2.9 centimeter. Okay, someone can say no, it is 2.99, or someone can say it is 3.01. Okay, so that means your answer is varying from 2.9 to 3.01. Okay, that means the length of this chalk actually is in interval. Okay. Moreover, if you see that I have already discussed about the round off that we do inside the computer, that rounding off is done if I write 3.4456. I want to round off here. So I write this 3.446. Okay? So now you see that means your actually this lies between this and this. This is the interval. But you carry on your calculations or computations using this, because you cannot handle very easily the interval numbers. So actually interval numbers is a set, is a closed set having infinite number of points, suppose for this example between 2.9 and 3.01, and you see the left value 2.9, it is the left bound, and this is the right bound 3.01. Okay, so if in general I can write this, the interval number as A1 and A3, just notation, where A1 is the left value, A3 is the right value or lower value and upper value. Okay, where remember this A1 is less than A3, okay, is less than A3. So this is a set, closed set A1, A3 having infinite number of points. Now this membership function or characteristic function for this I can write as mu a x or a bar x, because it is actually crisp when it is interval. So this I can write as, this is 0 for x less than a1, this is 1, the membership value of this interval is 1 if it is between A1 and A3, and again it is 0 if x greater than A3. So this way we define the membership function for this interval. So if I plot this, what will be the plot? You see, suppose you have A1 here and A3 here. Function says that when x is less than 1, it is 0, and suppose this is 0, this is 1. This axis is mu ax, this is your x. Okay, fine. Now a1 to a3, when this is in this interval, so this is 1. So this is your 1. Okay, a1 to a3, and otherwise this is 0. So this is your interval and membership function. Okay, understood how you define the interval? So, in practical application, this is very much essential and very much important to take in this as interval. Okay? As I already discussed about this thing, that coefficient in the differential equation also. If you have, suppose, a dy by dx is equal to by or bx. Okay? This a and b may be interval. If these are constant, you can very well solve. You know, very easy. But if I change into a as interval, suppose a1, a3 and b as b1, b3, then it will be difficult to solve. Okay? There are few methods, but sometimes those also fails depending upon the differential equation. Similarly, eigenvalue problem, etc. There all are interval. Similarly, those may be fuzzy. I will go little bit later about fuzzy number. So, this is about interval number, and this, if a1 is equal to a3, and remember this is in actually R, real number, okay, real number R. So, if a1 is equal to a3, so what we will get? This will get as number. That means a1. That means any real number I can write in terms of interval, same number. Means 2 I can write as 2, 2, where a1 equal to a3. Okay? This you remember. So, with this, if you have understood this interval number, now I will switch to fuzzy number. Okay? So, fuzzy number, actually it is the extension of this interval number, and we define, because it is a fuzzy now, I define this fuzzy number as a1 and a3 where your interval. So, in between this, there will be one more point in general, there may be two also. A2, this is actually peak, and this is left value, this is right. So, in general, I have this as fuzzy number, and if I plot this, in general I am telling, so, okay, so if I say this is A1, this is A3, and then this is A2, the peak. Okay, but it depends upon what fuzzy number, that we will do afterwards. Okay, so this is in general, if I say this is a fuzzy number, so we have three components now, A1, A2, A3, and remember these AIs, A1, A2, A3 belongs to R. Okay, now this A bar, you know it is a fuzzy set. Now, when it will be a fuzzy number, there are some conditions. If those conditions are satisfied, then this A bar is called a fuzzy number. That means a fuzzy number is a fuzzy set itself which satisfy certain conditions. So, fuzzy number then defined as, so fuzzy set A bar is a fuzzy number if the following conditions are satisfied. And those are very simple conditions. So, I am writing here. First one is, this A bar is a convex fuzzy set. Second is, A bar is a normalized fuzzy set. And third one is, its membership function is piecewise continuous. So, there are three conditions in general. First one is, A is convex fuzzy set, and you understand what is convex fuzzy set, we already have discussed. It is a normalized fuzzy set. Okay, normalized, you know, it's at least one x should be there such that its membership function should be 1. So, if I say this is 1, so then this is a normalized fuzzy set. So, if it is A bar, so it is normalized, it is convex, those conditions are satisfied that for convexity, and this is piecewise continuous. Okay, so then I can say that A bar is a fuzzy number. Okay, now if you see, that means normalized means I told that there exists a point x or a x here such that mu a bar x is 1. Okay? And those already I have done. If I take suppose here alpha dash, some value of this membership function, suppose this is mu a bar x, this is your x. Okay? So if I now say draw a line from alpha horizontal parallel to this x axis and here same. So you see here we are getting what? 2 points on x axis. And if I denote this as a1 alpha and this as a3 alpha, what are those? Those are alpha cut or not? You know alpha cut. So for this alpha membership value, we have, so see, this is a fuzzy number. Now you see, I can have different alphas here, means the value is from 0 to 1. Okay, so if I have, suppose, let us take first alpha, so this is an interval or not? You get an interval a1 alpha and a3 alpha for this membership value. Similarly, for alpha dash, you will again get another interval and that is your a1 alpha dash and a3 alpha dash. So again you will get another interval a1 alpha dash and a3 alpha dash. And you remember that also, that if alpha is less than alpha dash, and I already told that these intervals are set, so this set then will be what? Which one will be larger? You see this one, alpha is less than alpha dash, but corresponding to this interval is larger than this set. Means this for alpha dash, if I write a alpha dash, okay, so this will be a proper subset of a alpha is greater. So now you see here one interesting thing, that we have fuzzy number like this. Now if you think that these are all, you see, these are all union of intervals or not? If I take from here different values of alpha and draw horizontal line and get all intervals and take union, you will get the fuzzy number or fuzzy set a bar or not. So we have two types of arithmetic operations for fuzzy number. One is using alpha cut, another is with respect to membership values, membership function. Okay? So before going into the arithmetic of fuzzy number, we will first revise those interval arithmetic. I hope you have done somewhere interval arithmetic. So let me start with interval arithmetic or operations of interval or interval operation. Okay? So suppose I have two intervals A and B and I denote this A by A1, A3 and B by B1, B3. So then I can write all those operations, addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, etc. So I can write first the addition. That means A plus B is equal to A1, A3 plus B1, B3. And remember, all these A1, A3, B1, B3 belongs to real line R. Okay? So this is very simple addition component wise will add, means A1 plus B1 and A3 plus B3. This is very simple, A1 plus B1 and A3 plus B3. Okay? So this is your addition. Second is subtraction. A minus B, better write A plus B like this, A minus B And this will be what directly I am writing now. It will be A1 first minus last. A1 minus B3 and A3 minus B1. This is the subtraction. Then product or multiplication. A into B. What will be that? A into B will be what? Means actually I have to take combination of all product and minimum. Combination of all product maximum. But we write here in terms of AND and OR. Okay? So if I write that we will have A1 B1 and A1 B3 and A3 B1 and A3 B3. This is your first component. AND means you will take minimum. We know the definition of AND. So all these product and minimum. Similarly for right value, this is OR. A1 B3 or A3 B1 or A3 B3. This is your product. Now similarly division. A divide B, we write here how? A1 by B1 and A1 by B3 and A3 by B1 and A3 by B3. And same right component as AND replaced by OR. So it will be A1 by B1 or A1 by B3 or A3 by B1 or A3 by B3. So this is your division. Now if I want to have inverse, A inverse, reciprocal, means I should have A1, A3 inverse, okay? A1, A3 inverse, how you will write? 1 by? It will be 1 by A1 and 1 by A3, first component, minimum of that, 1 by A1, 1 by A3, and this is 1 by A1 or 1 by A3. Okay, whatever minimum, left, maximum, right. Okay, remember this interval operations is for R, real line, having positive, negative, both. If I change this R to R plus, what will happen? If I say these operations are valid on R plus, minimum will become? No, I am asking, suppose addition, subtraction, no problem, it is straightforward. Multiplication and division, whether there will be some change, some simplification. If I change, if I say that interval operation on R plus, means all are positive. Yes. When this interval operations, if it is in R plus, okay, in R plus, that means all are positive. Now he is correct, then this multiplication will be simply A1, B1, because you know all are positive. So A1, B1 will be lowest, means minimum, and the maximum will be A3, B3. So this or AND or no need. So then if it is R plus, all are positive, so we will have for multiplication A into B, we can write directly as A1, B1 and A3, B3. Okay? Similarly, I can have for this also. A1 by B3, yes. So 4 dash I can write A1 by B3, A1 by B3, yes, correct, A3 by B1. Okay, yes. Subtraction? We'll get you take example and see why it will be changed. A1 minus B3 may be, then what? I am telling A1, B1, but result I am not telling it is in R plus. Only I am telling A1, A3, B1, B3 in R plus. Input is in R plus, output I don't know. It may be in R plus minus whatever. It may be 0 also. Negative will be there, but it is in R minus. What is there? Means full R minus infinity plus infinity. Okay? So this is okay. Now similarly for inverse also. What will get inverse? Left side 1 by A3, right 1 by A1, because we know that A1 is less than A3. That is the definition of interval. A1 is less than A3. So we will get 1 by A3, 1 by A1. Okay? So here similarly I can write also about max and min, if you remember. Means A max B means, A or B. So you can very well write whether it is R plus or R. All the components you have to take R. Similarly, A and B. Okay? So let us take one example, very simple example. Try to compute all these operations. Take A1 as minus 3, 5, not A1, AB as minus 2, 7. Find A plus B, A minus B, A by B, A into B. Okay, fine. So this is very easy. A plus B is what? Component wise I have to add, so it will be minus 3 plus minus 2, that means minus 5. 5 plus 7 is 12. Okay? A minus B will be minus 3 minus 7. So it will be minus 10 and 5 plus 2. So it will be 7. Like that, A into B, you have to multiply all. Minus 3 into minus 2, that is minus 6, minus 3 into 7, minus 21. Okay, then 5 into 2, minus 10, 5 into 7, 35. Minimum here, maximum here. Okay, so you can write similarly division. This remember, I forgot to write one thing. In the division, remember that denominators B1 and B3 should not be 0. Condition is, I forgot to write B1 there in the definition. B1 and B3 should not be 0.
That is obvious.
Obvious? Why obvious?
The rule of division, that shouldn't be 0.
No. It depends upon the interval, na? Actually, see, I cannot have minus 1, 1 divided by. See, actually, what happens? Minus 1 to 1, if I divide by minus 2, 2. What will happen? Tell me. This looks simple. Looks simple. Minus 1, 1 divided by minus 2, 2. Is it possible? Can you find all the divisions here? See, actually, here you have infinite number of points, means 0 is included here. 0 is included also here, so you will have 0 by 0 somewhere that you cannot find. So those are the difficulties actually. If you see, these are very easy. Okay, when you are finding these, what sir has given means A plus, but if like this is there inside your eigenvalue problem or Gauss elimination, okay, so inside this all linear programming problem you are solving looks very easy to solve. Those who are not working on this, they will think linear programming problem, what is this, I can solve. But if these things are there, you have to handle that accordingly, otherwise you will get absurd result. Okay. No, it depends upon the book and you can put comma, you cannot. Only you should remember this is left value, this is right value. In some books it is there minus, comma, here comma. In some books also this is given by this first bracket also. But usually because it closed set, means if I consider, so I am giving minus 1 mark. This is your choice. Comma you can give, may or may not, okay? Understood? So this was for operations for interval. Similarly, we have operations for fuzzy number. So operations of fuzzy number, I can have two types. One is through alpha cut. So I have already shown that if you have a fuzzy number, that is a fuzzy set, and that fuzzy set I can write in terms of different alpha cuts. So if those alpha cuts I write, you have seen that those alpha cuts are what? Actually those are just interval. Okay, so if you, those are intervals, so you can use these operations very easily. No, and those union of all those, union means what? You have 0 to 1 infinite number of points. So what is step size you will take? 0.1, 0.2, but all, there is no limit, no. Then only this piecewise smooth is there, all you cannot have. So then we use sometime that with membership function also. So let us write one or two with alpha cut, then I will go to membership function, how will you handle that. Main in interval arithmetic, actually division, subtraction, these are the difficulties there, okay. Although nowadays tools are there, IntLab tools are there. There all those operations automatically does, but we are not succeeding on this. Anyway, there are limitations also, okay. So operations on fuzzy number. So first is with respect to alpha cut.
Sir, that is software or MATLAB extension?
This is a software, IntLab software, but it is MATLAB inside that it is there, but it is not freely available. Earlier it was freely available, IntLab. It is, I think, from Texas or somewhere they have developed. And they are developing and inserting more tools there in IntLab. With respect to alpha cut, so I have already told that I can write the fuzzy set or fuzzy number in terms of different alpha cuts. So suppose I have two alpha cuts, A alpha as A1 alpha, A3 alpha, and B alpha as B1 alpha and B3 alpha. Okay, so these are two intervals, so I can use all those operations that I have written, addition, subtraction, so I will write only one, that addition, others you can write yourself, this is only, the suffix will be there, I mean superscripts will be there in terms of alpha. So I have A alpha plus B alpha as A1 alpha plus B1 alpha and A3 alpha plus B3 alpha. Similarly, minus whatever definitions we have already written. This minus this, this minus this. Similarly, division, this would not be 0 in division, etc. Okay? So the important thing is now in terms of membership function. Okay? So in with respect to membership function, our aim is to add two fuzzy numbers A and B. Okay, I have two fuzzy numbers A and B. Okay, I denote for these numbers as X, for B I denote by Y, and I want to add this A plus B. Okay, so this, suppose it's sorry a bar and b bar because it is fuzzy and our notation is bar. Okay, so mu a bar x membership function for this a, and this is for mu b bar x, and after addition I will denote as mu a bar plus b bar z. These are notations. Okay, if I want to add plus, subtraction, minus, similarly division, multiplication, maximum, minimum. Okay, so with this in mind, let us write what will be. Actually, see, I have membership value of this. Okay, I have membership values of this. Those will be given. A bar and B bar are fuzzy set. Now, I can add this. First is this A plus B. So its membership value will be mu A bar plus. Should write this plus. This is our notation here. B bar Z is equal to, or take or on Z is equal to X plus Y, and then mu A bar X and mu B bar Y. Understood? So when we will take example, it will be more clear. First you take the AND of those X and Y, mu A bar X and mu bar B bar Y, and remember Z is X plus Y. Okay, and then take OR, minimum, then maximum. Okay, and this on Z equal to X plus Y. So if I change now to subtraction, so A bar minus B bar, this I will write as A bar minus B bar Z. Only change will be where? Here, Z is equal to X minus Y. Okay, Z is equal to X minus Y for all those Z, or for all those X minus Y, means whatever value you will get for X and Y. Okay, so this mu A bar X and mu B bar Y. If I write division, so this will get as mu A bar B bar Z is equal to, or here Z is equal to X by Y, and remember Y again should not be 0. Okay, so X by Y mu A bar X and mu B bar Y. Fourth, I forgot this into, okay, if it is into or multiplication, so mu A bar multiply B bar Z, or Z is equal to X into Y, and mu A bar X and mu B bar Y. Okay, so with this I can write minimum and maximum also here. 5, minimum and maximum, that I was telling, if it is minimum, so A and B, or A bar and B bar. Okay, and I will write this as or, then Z is equal to X and Y, and mu A bar X and mu B bar Y. Is it okay? Now sixth, A bar or B bar, this is your minimum, okay, and this is your maximum, or X or Y and mu A bar X and mu B bar Y. Okay, so let us take now one example and see how we can find this. Take two fuzzy set A bar as 2, 1, 3.5 and B bar as 3.1 4.5. Find A plus B means membership. A plus B also set also you can find if you know the membership values. So if I plot this, what will get A? See 2 1. So this is X, this is mu A bar X. So if I have 2 here, 3 here, and this is 0, this is 1 membership value. So for 2 it is going to 1, okay, and for 3 if it is 0.5, so I substitute for 3, I will get like this. So this is your fuzzy set, okay, if I have like this, okay. So 2 1 3.5 similarly I can have mu B bar X the plot. Find A plus B using this membership values of A and B, A bar and B bar. See, I have to find A bar plus B bar. So see, these are ordered pair, na? So how many will get? 2 plus 3, 2 plus 4, 3 plus 3, 3 plus 4. So that means I have the combination as 2 plus 3, 2 plus 4, it is 5, 6, and 3 plus 3 also will come here, and 3 plus 4. Remember, 2 is coming from A bar, 3 is coming from B bar. Similarly, here 2 and 4 coming from A bar and B bar respectively, 3 and 3, this and this. Okay? Now you use those definitions. So I have then, for this I have mu A bar plus B bar, Z is your 5, first component, first value, 5 is equal to, or Z is your 5 and X, Y are your 2 and 3, Z is equal to X plus Y, so X plus Y. And inside you have mu A bar X. So that means mu A bar 2 and mu B bar 3. Understood? So here it is simply, or mu A bar 2 is 1 and mu B bar 3 for this B, remember this 3 is coming from B bar. So this is 1, so it will give 1. That means first point in A bar plus B bar is the element 5 whose membership value is 1. First you got. Now come to this, we have 2 numbers here, 2 plus 4, 3 plus 3. Here actually you have 2 comma, that 2 components are there. So now I have mu A bar plus B bar at 6. And 6 are coming from 2. So I have then, or 6 is 2 plus 4 and 6 is 3 plus 3. Understood? Now I have, now I will write directly mu A bar 2. Mu A bar 2 is 1. Okay? So 1. And mu B bar 4, that is 0.5. And now 3 and 3 I have to write. Mu A bar 3 is 0.5. And mu B bar 3, it is 1. So I have then, or 1 and 0.5 is 0.5. 0.5 and 1 is 0.5. And this or will be 0.5. So second element is 6. Whose membership value is 0.5. Similarly, last one, let me complete this. Yes, you may be correct. So mu A bar plus B bar at 7. Yes, 7, that you are telling, 7. So this, or 7 is coming from 3 plus 4, okay? And this mu a bar 3 from A, that is 0.5. And mu b bar 4 is 0.5, so result is 0.5. Is it okay? So I have then the set A bar plus B bar as 5, 1, 6, 0.5, 7, 0.5. So this is your addition considering your membership values. Understood? So in this way you can plot also this as we plotted that A bar and B bar also you will plot. So this also you can plot and see what is happening. Okay, similarly homework is minus and max and if possible product. Okay, thank you.